Dagna, what have you learned of Samson?
He should be dead. I mean, you could make a hat out of red lyrium and kill people, especially the wearer. Samson's armor is genius. To do all this and not go insane, he must be resistant. Or he is insane. Or both.
You're not comforting me, Dagna. He's dangerous either way.
Oh, fine. I just need time and tools. People. And red lyrium. For tests, you see?
Is that wise?
Everything is safe if handled properly. And you don't touch it long. Or breathe it. I mentioned the hat, right? No hat. Time and resources, Inquisitor. I'll get what you want. Now shoo! I've work to do.
Civil war over, Orlais is focusing on rebuilding. Inquisitor. I have not asked in a while. How goes the hunt for Samson?
We're close. I know it.
If I can help you any further...
Thank you. I appreciate it. Work?
this is where the Sulavine blade was lost. Lost or misused. There is a reason it was never reclaimed. There's an altar.
Be careful. This place is far too quiet for my liking.
Part of the sword. The elves broke it after all.
They performed a ritual they did not understand. It appears they paid the consequences for it. That corpse was possessed by a pride demon. I doubt it was alone.
There must be more altars.
You've witnessed past events in the Fade, Solas, or the memories of it. But the Fade distorts reality. Surely it cannot offer a true reflection of what occurred.
Are your own memories any different? The truth is never precise, regardless of where you are.
The final piece of the sword. Perhaps Dagna can find a way to restore it.
Just as I remember it.
You didn't tell me you'd been here before.
After the Blight ended, I came here to see Justinia. She was just Dorothea then, a revered mother.
It's peaceful here. You must have good memories of this place.
It was a place of comfort. It is good to see it still untouched by Corypheus.
Liliana! Is that you?
Sister Natalie, what are you doing here? I thought you were in Val Rayo.
No, I've been here since Justinia died. This place makes me feel like she's still with us.
Inquisitor, this is Natalie, a trusted friend.
Wait, Inquisitor? You brought the Inquisitor here? My lord, forgive me for not recognizing you earlier.
You owe me 20 readings of the Canticle of Trials for that insult.
He doesn't mean it. Natalie, listen. There is something hidden here. Something Justinia left for me.
Oh, really? What is it?
I don't know, but we'll find it. I'm curious to see what brought us all here. Justinia's letter came with instructions for me. They were a little cryptic. Always remember that faith sprung from a barren branch, that light has no fear of darkness. Above all, that strength lives in an open heart.
She must be hinting at something in here. Let's look around.
Do they still sing verses from the benedictions every Friday? That canticle was Justinia's favorite. Sorry to keep you waiting.
Liliana, stop. What are you doing?
I'm protecting us. They never sing the benedictions here on Fridays, Natalie. Something so simple. And you got it so wrong. I wanted to believe, but you were lying from the start. Keep that pretty mouth shut if you must, dear. You've already told me everything I need to know. The prickleweed burrs on your hem, talking about the sun rising through the breach. It all points to a single place. Morel in the Dales, Grand Cleric Victoire's Bastion. She sent you, didn't she? Victoire was always an opportunist.
Who is this grand cleric? I've never heard of her.
An experienced cleric. She never agreed with Justinia, but kept her ideas to herself. I suppose now, with Justinia dead, she thought she could make her move.
I want to know what this grand cleric planned here.
She sent Natalie here to see what Justinia was hiding, no?
The Inquisition has turned Thidas away from the true Chantry. It must be stopped.
Stop us? You must be joking.
Mother Victoire is well loved by many. The Inquisition has more enemies than you know.
And Victoire thinks she can ally with them.
We don't have to be at odds, Natalie. You could come with us. Join the Inquisition.
I was called to serve the Grand Cleric. I will not betray her. Kill me then. I am not afraid to die for my beliefs. At least I still know what I believe.
Release her, Leliana. She's no threat.
The Grand Cleric?
She is one woman. We are the Inquisition.
The Inquisitor has spoken. Run. Tell your mistress that she has a choice. The Inquisition is coming. No! This can't be it. There's nothing here.
Check again. Perhaps the box itself is a puzzle. She seemed the puzzling sort.
No, it's just an empty box. There's a message carved in the lid. The left hand should lay down her burden. She's releasing me. The divine has a long reach, but it is always her left hand that stretches out. 1,000 lies, 1,000 deaths. Her commands, but my conscience that bore the consequences.
She apologized in the Fade. She said she failed you. This is what she meant.
All this time, Justinia carried the fear that she was using me, just like I'd been used in the past. But Marjolaine's games were trifles. Justinia gambled with the fate of nations. She needed me. No one else could have done what I did. She knows that.
And you have to let it go. Let her go. You don't owe her anything anymore.
If it were not for you, I would have killed Natalie and called it a good thing. Thank you for showing me what was right when I couldn't see it for myself. There are things that must be said, but not here. I will see you back at Skyhold.
Inquisitor, you have a moment.
Templars. Corypheus must have sent them here for some reason.
Lyrium smuggling would be profitable around here. Must be an old dwarven outpost.
What was it for?
Trade, maybe? Your guess is as good as mine.
I could do that if you wish. Won't be the last.
We may be too close to the surface for these to count as deep roads. But have I mentioned I hate the deep roads?
tunnel.
Let's hope that holds the Darkspawn back. Our movements.
Make their living from valuables they find in the deep roads.
Thank you.
Inquisitor.
For judgment this day, Inquisitor, I must present Captain Tom Rainier, formerly known to us as Warden Blackwall. His crimes... well, you are aware of his crimes. It was no small expense to bring him here, but the decision of what to do with him is now yours.
I didn't think this would be easy, but it's harder than I thought.
Another thing to regret. What did you have to do to release me?
Josephine called in a few favors. There are enough people out there who owe the Inquisition.
And what happens to the reputation the Ambassador has so carefully cultivated? The world will learn how you've used your influence. They'll know the Inquisition is corrupt.
Once the world is back to normal, no one will even remember this.
I'll remember. I accepted my punishment. I was ready for all this to end. Why would you stop it? What becomes of me now?
Blackwall intended you join the Wardens. I will let them decide your fate. But only when Corypheus is dead. For now, Tom Rainier, the Inquisition needs you.
As you command.
I'm told not all survive the joining, and the life of a true Warden is difficult.
If I die, it will be no less than I deserve. And if I live, I'll make it count. I am grateful for this, Inquisitor. And I will serve for as long as I can.
I expected ruins.
They were. As you see, the Inquisition has not been idle.
Would it be possible to meet the Herald before we return to Ghislaine?
My dear Laurent, for you, anything. Allow me to present Inquisitor Trevelyan.
Your worship, you do us great honor.
Inquisitor, this is my dear Bastien's sister, Grand Cleric Marceline, and his son, Duke Laurent of the Council of Heralds.
Madame de Fer has told us what great trials you faced, trying to save my poor brother's life.
The Maker called my father to his side. It was valiant of you to champion him in his final hours.
All I did was kill a Wyvern.
Well, truly, you are too humble, Inquisitor. My family is deeply grateful for your efforts.
Would you mind waiting for me in the chapel, my dears? The Inquisitor and I have business to discuss.
It has been our very great pleasure, Herald.
This has been quite the triumph, hasn't it? They just adore you.
Duke Bastien's family seem quite pleasant.
Ordinarily, I would have warned you that Marceline has the temper of a hungry vulture, but she's quite taken with you. Laurent is a dear, almost as pious as his aunt, and new to a seat of great power in the Empire. And Marceline is one of the strongest voices among the Grand Clerics. Now they will both come to us for advice. The Inquisition is truly a power now, and there's no telling how far its influence will reach. But enough of this talk. Here, I have something for you. I commissioned this ring from the Formari, the greatest enchanters in all Thedas, for you.
This is a generous gift. Thank you, Vivian.
Once it was customary for the Circles to craft enchantments for their staunchest friends and allies. And you have been both. I must go to see my guests now. Another time, darling.
I should go.
Here I thought we were just getting to the good part.
Grand Cleric Victoire has offered the Ambassador support for the Inquisition.
I'm told that Ambassador Montillier is pleased with the restraint you showed in Valence.
Ugh, she's positively beside herself. I will never hear the end of it.
Niceness before knives, Liliana. Haven't I always told you?
Will that be all, my lady?
For now.
I love making new friends, don't you?
It was a gamble, Inquisitor, but it paid off. If you hadn't been with me at Valence, I would have killed Natalie. I'd have told you that I didn't have a choice. But there is always a choice. I am more than this. I am more than what Justinia made me.
Do you resent Justinia for what she did?
How can I, when there is so much between us? When she gave her life for peace? No, I believe her intentions were pure. Most intentions are.
What does this mean for my Inquisition? Will you still be my spymaster?
Of course. I would not give up my post. Not after everything we've built. I just know now that I shouldn't ignore my heart. Mercy is not always a weakness.
You've exceeded her. She could never have imagined the power you now hold.
And now I will know how to use that power wisely. I have to stay true to who I really am. Before a spymaster, left hand, or bard. I almost lost myself.
There was no way to save Alistair, was there?
We don't know that he's dead.
But lost in the Fade? As good as dead, then. We will toast to his memory.
Anything I should know?
I've nothing to report at the moment.
I'll leave you to your work. Is there anything I should know?
Not at present.
That's all for now.
Another time, then.
heard you found something that had to do with wardens. Would have liked to have seen it.
How shall I refer to you? Rainier or Blackwall?
I've gotten used to Blackwall. Perhaps we could treat it as less of a name and more of a title. Almost like Inquisitor. Reminds me of what I ought to be.
Everyone needs something to aspire to.
Exactly. I'm glad you understand.
Is there anything you actually know about the Wardens, or did you make it all up?
I made very little up. I also feared you knew enough to contradict me. Warden Blackwall told me a bit before my initiation, but it is a secretive order. Not even the most senior Wardens know all there is to know.
Now we know why you were never worried about Corypheus's calling.
Yes. I have none of the Warden's abilities and none of the drawbacks. Still, I would have fought through the darkest pits of the Deep Roads like any true Warden. There's more to it than being able to sense Darkspawn. Warden Blackwall would have agreed.
The Wardens at Adamant listened to you. They saw you as one of their own.
Perhaps it takes an outsider to show how much of yourself you've lost. I never understood the reality of being a Warden. I only saw the ideal. I suppose I reminded them of something they'd forgotten.
You have a lot of respect for the Wardens.
They take all men, from the most noble to the most despicable, and make them equals. I needed to believe something like that was possible.
Why did Blackwall want to recruit you?
He never told me. I don't know what he saw that day besides some wreck starting a bar fight. That night, I taught some village militia a painful lesson about harassing a tavern girl. Didn't know I had an audience.
Did you start a fight while drunk?
Maker, no. I wasn't drunk, but I was trying to get there. Told the girl to keep the wine coming. She couldn't, not with those louts bothering her. Something had to be done.
We'll continue this another time.
That's what the nobles say. Wardens don't say anything. They just go to work.
Inquisitor.
Better?
From Haven's Fire come we, the Able True.
Hey, boss. How are you?
See you later, Bull.
Nice talking with you, boss.
Hey, you. You have time? It's not a question. Let's go. I've got something I want to do for you. Just come. You won't need your gear and stuff.
Sarah, explain.
Ah, just come on, will you? I haven't wanted to do this with anyone for a long time.
We're eating on a roof.
They're horrible, right? And raisins, ugh. I friggin' still hate cookies.
You know, this is about as far from what I expected as we could get.
I got caught stealing when I was little, yeah? You get alienage or worse for that, but the Lady Emerald took me in. She was sick and couldn't have children. I had no parents. It worked out. Anyway, she gets a year sicker, so I ask her about cookies. Because mums make cookies, I can pass that down or something. Turns out, she couldn't cook. She missed that talk with her mum. The one she made, she bought and pretended. Ah, right. Well, no, she was a bitch. She hid buying them by keeping me away from the baker. She did that by lying that he didn't like me, didn't like elves. She let me hate so she could protect her pride. I hated him so much, and I hated... Well, she died, and I hate pride. Pride cookies. But this Inquisition thing is working out, so I figured I could make some... Inquisition cookies? Because then I could like them again. Oh, it's stupid.
You know what? That would be great.
See, I knew. Wait, really? Because it seemed friggin' daft every step to me. Suppose it's not really about them. I hate learning lessons. Makes my stomach hurt. Anyway, I'll throw this rubbish away. Next time will be better, yeah?
Sarah, anytime. Can we get off the roof now?
Oh, yes, please. Smells like bird and dank. This part, not a good idea. Thanks, yeah? Feels good, this.
Enough without cell swords.
Look at their captain. What good could that bring? You have one eye.
Mercs are merc.
It started out helping, taking the fear away. I won't take too much. I am not that.
I'll talk to you later.
How do you know?
Have you seen other way?
You have one eye.
Your worship. It's good to see you.
What do the people make of us?
There's scarcely a noble house that hasn't openly pledged its support to us.
Any visiting dignitaries I should watch out for?
You've already met Grand Cleric Marceline. Lady Vivienne helped arrange the visit. The timing is most curious.
Why?
Word has circulated that Grand Cleric Marceline will be instrumental in choosing our next divine. What are Lady Vivienne's intentions, I wonder?
That Dalish elf who joined us is eager, to say the least.
The Dalish possess great knowledge. We should be honored to have him with us. Inquisitor. Let us begin.
Any luck charting the area?
I did what I could, Your Worship. This space has nothing but... space. If there's nothing valuable here, I say let Corypheus have it.
I'm sure there's something deadly and enchanted and so on underneath all this sand.
I did find something for you. Old dwarven ruins, on the surface. Impossible, but there you go. The Red Templars are digging them out. With Venatori supervision.
Whatever they want, we must beat them to it.
I just saw Red Templars heading northwest to here. They might be a good start. I found this map on a dead one. Maybe it shows where they're headed. Good luck.
Word for you.
Greetings.
Ours shall be the burden of knowledge, to take into the earth and prove us worthy.
That's from the Chant of Light. Is that a thing? Do people go about reciting from it like that?
The righteous shall carry the Maker's word to every corner of his house.
All right, well, good luck.
Are those lights in the distance? They may be campfires.
Let's have a look.
Dying of thirst. The well's dry.
Orso, Andraste guide them to the Maker's side.
Do me a favor. We run out of water, just stick a knife in me.
Like a leaf. Go look for one of our camps. I'm certain the Inquisition will take you in.
They will? I'll go. Thank you.
Varric, when you were at the Winter Palace, did you meet Celine's handmaidens?
The ones that finish each other's sentences? Yes, I did.
They were asking me about you. Personal things.
How personal?
Something about your chest hair, and whether you were currently involved with anyone.
Huh. Creepy.
Burial chamber, I think.
Inquisitor.
I know. You thought he'd be taller. The Inquisition can protect you. Think you can find our camps?
I think so, Master Kunari. Thank you.
It's a pleasure to see a new face. Watch out for those Tevinter mages. They aren't so kindly as Hunter Mag, which is me.
Anything I should look out for?
Watch out if you have to fill your water skins. There's more monsters than normal staking out the oasis.
Do you know what the Venatori mages are doing here?
Arguing amongst themselves, mostly. I think they're trying to find a way inside that tomb with the two statues. It's locked tight as far as I can tell.
Why come out here for game? What do you hunt?
Not game. I bring back fine furs and shiny teeth they cut and sew in Orlais. I'm not the only hunter here. Valroyo is always hungry for the best. He can make a fortune feeding that beast. Quillback spines, for example. All the fashion for men's hats last winter.
Farewell.
Keep your water handy.
Lively for a wasteland, I'll give it that.
Yes!
Let's look around.
Venatori hiding everywhere in this desert.
This might interest you, sir.
We're not getting in that way.
The Venatori want these tombs. Let's see if they found another way in.
Why, Cassandra, I've never seen you smile so much.
I am not smiling.
Now you're not, but only because I pointed it out.
I am not a giddy schoolgirl, Dorian.
That would be easier to believe if you hadn't just blushed.
This stonework is old. And I don't mean just a couple ages old. We're talking old.
How can you tell?
You think we don't have dwarven ruins up in Parvalin? My old Tamasrin saw this place. She'd rope it off until the scholars counted the grains in every block.
Thank you.
does the Qunari priesthood tell your people about losing the war?
The usual. Water comes, water goes, but eventually the tides wear away the mountain, blah, blah, blah.
They've been fighting Tevinter for centuries and still haven't won.
Wait, you think we've been at war all this time?
It's barely an eye-watering slap fight, I'll grant you, but every now and again it heats up.
That's just force of habit. A real invasion's different.
But what are they waiting for?
Don't know. Someone to tell someone to tell someone it's on again, I guess. Guys were lazy. Should have spotted us coming hours ago.
Inquisitor, if you have a moment.
I don't have time.